Hi everyone, so this is our Appium tutorial session 6, and this tutorial will be looking into how we can automate the Android seekbar. The seekbar, what I have usually found, like if we changing the brightness utilizing dragging and dropping the seekbar, or any e-commerce site changing the price range, you will find the seekbar. Okay, so how you can automate this in the seekbar, we will find out. So in our case, I'll be automating Android native brightness app, and we'll be doing our operation on the brightness seekbar. Okay, so let's have a look into it. Okay, first of all, I've connected my device using the MobiZen. This is my device, and this is my brightness level app. So this is my seekbar. Okay, so you can see that if you click on the seekbar and drag and drop to the particular X and Y coordinate locations, so according to the brightness will get changed. Okay, the same thing is we can see for mobile web applications, as well as in you can find in hybrid application also. Okay, so let me take it to my clips. Okay, I have created the code for brightness control of my device and Android seekbar. This is a native applications, and so my application has been, this code has been divided into 3 stages. All those costs are important. So let me explain you step by step. First of all, I've taken one Appium driver for mobile element driver, and that I'll be using in my before class. So in my before class is a setup class. It will set up all the brightness capabilities, all the things before the actual testing start. Okay. So in that case, I've taken the desired capabilities CAP cap object. The desired capabilities for Android, and in that cap object we are storing the set capability as a mobile capability, the device name. The device name for my device is 539E3EE5. Okay, device name you will found from your about phone section from settings. New command type mode, the new command type mode given as a 120 second. The app package and app activity, the two things are given. In my earlier tutorial, I've shown you guys how to find the app package and app activity. Okay. Platform name I provided is a platform.android, and the Android version currently I'm using 6.0.1 MMB29M. So the next thing is that we have taken the Appium driver. Now we have instantiated the Appium driver in the before class. So in this case, I have taken the new Android driver that instantiating from the Appium driver itself, and you are pointing out to the URL. In this URL, the URL that the Appium server will run our script. So my Appium server, let me stop my Appium server first. Okay. So my Appium server, I'm running on the localhost 127.0.0.1 and on the port 4723. Okay, so in this, the URL I have to mention that the Appium server will run. And the Android driver, I'm mentioning all this URL along with all the capabilities I've set for my devices. Okay, implicit timeout, this is a Selenium default timeout I've given 30 seconds. Okay, so this is my paper class. Let me take you to my tear down classes. So in the tear down classes, if driver found not equal to null, it will first printing this options, the console and output show as a destroying test environment, and then driver will get quit. Okay, so let me take you to my test classes, the main class. Okay, so inside the test class, I have taken all the elements inside the try and catch block. So if due to any reason we are not able to find any elements, so it will catch the exceptions and print it. For that we have used no such element exception. Okay, and for the same thing that for my devices, the app I'm going to operate, that brightness app, I've taken the same utilizing the UI automator. In the UI automator, the field I'm looking into, this select brightness level text would be displayed, the current percentage will get displayed, and we'll be finding this seekbar node details. I am using this seekbar class here, android.wizard.seekbar. This class I'll be using, and later on the things I'll be finding the close and select footer should be displayed. Okay, so if you navigate to the code, I can you can see the level. So mobile element level as if like current brightness level. The current brightness level I'm using the find by Android UI automator. Driver.element 5 Android UI automator. You can generally use the XPath also, find element by ID. For my case, I'm using the find element by Android UI automator. Here I'm passing the text select brightness level. If the text got displayed, so it will face the element. The select brightness level. Okay, the text. In the later part, the current value I'm fetching as a by ID, find element by ID. Accordingly, the close footer option I'm fetching find element by ID, and the seekbar I'm fetching by find element by class name. So let me show you this. This is my just hold on. This is my seekbar. So the class name I'm seeing that android.user.seekbar. This is the class name. This is the unique class name of this app. Okay. So I'm using this find element by class name. One more thing, like if you have several class name, the same class name for applicable for two or three elements, you can also utilize the same. Then you have to do that get instance method for which instance you want, which particular element you want to click. Okay. Okay. Now let me take you to my seekbar again. Okay. If we scroll the seekbar from this position to the end positions, we can see. Like let me open my device. This device is open. Okay. So initial x and y coordinate will be same. Now if we drag the same seekbar to the designated target location, we can see that y location will be same. Only the x location will be changed. Okay, because this is what you are doing. We are doing some horizontal activity, horizontal scrolling. So the x-axis will be changed, and y will be remain same. So first you have to find the starting position in this way integer value I have taken. So integer starting x will be seekbar dot get locations or get x. So it will face the starting x locations. Same way we will find the starting y locations. Now I have to find the whatever the width of the seekbar, total width. Total width the seekbar. So how we can find the total width? So starting x. Let me show you this way. Okay. So starting seekbar dot get size dot get width. Utilizing that, we will face the total size of the seekbar, and the index location will be starting x plus seekbar total width. If you want to, scroll it fully. So the starting x locations, and then I'm scrolling the whole width of the seekbar. Okay. So if you want to scroll it the fully 100%, then we'll be using that index location of the starting x plus seekbar get size or get width. In the next line, I'm printing console for my console output the heading, current percentage, and the footer. And after that, I'm using the touch actions. This is the touch actions class. I've taken an action object of the touch action class. In the action object, I've taken first. Let me delete this portions. In that, I've taken action dot long press. You can also use press, but sometimes I have seen that it's not work. So better to use the long press. It will press and hold for it, and then we'll drag it to the designated locations. So action dot long press. Given the indicator coordinate as a starting x and y, and moving to the end coordinate, index and starter y will be remain same. Then dot release dot perform. So this is the action I'm performing. After the action has been performed, we will be asserting contents that whatever the current value. If the current value is 100%, that current value I will find from this. This is the current value indicator. So I have to check. I have dragged my seekbar to the 100%. Now it should get changed to 100%, right? So this will face the current value, and we assert that if it is 100%, then we will print the same in the console, and the test case will get passed. Okay. So now let's have a look. I will run it, and we have a look on it. Okay. So running on this test engine class. First, it. Okay. First, I have to run my Appium server. So my device has been opened. Let me run it again. So test script has started. Let's see. First, it will try to open the brightness app. It will print the all the default value. Then it will navigate to the 100%. Okay. So we can see that from the console output, the starting brightness was 40%. And all the things element was present, so thus printed the element. And we are asserting contents after the touch action has been performed. Now it is the percentage has been raised to 100%. Okay, so test script was passed successfully. Now there is another question. If you just want to navigate to the 50% of the seekbar, if you want to increase your brightness 50%, okay, so how we can achieve it? So you can also achieve it same way. So for this case, the x coordinate will only be changed. So index coordinate I'm using starting x positions, whatever the seekbar width into 0.5. okay, 0.5. so half of the width I'm navigating from the starting x coordinate. So for this I'll be using the int 50x. Make sure guys, here I'm using the double value, like 0.5 is 0.51, the double value. So I have to downcast. I'm basically downcasting this double value to the integer value. Okay, so it may depend on the device. That's why I'm using the 0.51. For my device, if I use 0.51 after the downcasting, it will navigate to the 50% of the brightness. Okay. So some little bit change will be there based on the device, but almost will be same. I mean, whatever the total width, it will navigate to a 50% width. Okay. Because I'm downcasting the double value to the integer value. Now let's have a look into it. As of now, I'm commenting of this assertion part. Okay. Just let's have a look into it. Brightness control, and let's see our app. It will open my app. It will print the current brightness, and it will navigate to the 50%. Current brightness is 40%. Navigate to it 50%, and then it's closing. Okay. So you can see from the result, the current brightness is 40% has been changed to 50% successfully. All the elements are present. And the script hasn't passed successfully. So guys, we have seen that how we can utilize the touch action classes to for any horizontal scrolling of any seekbar. Yeah, if you want to perform any horizontal scrolling, you can use the touch action classes. Okay, same way, if you want to perform vertical scrolling, then in that case your x will be remain same, only y axis will be changed. So in that case, you have to put your y coordinate as the starting y, and end coordinate of y will be changed only. You can also perform the vertical scrolling utilizing the touch action classes. Okay, so I'll cover this, the vertical scrolling, in my next tutorial. And so that's all for today. Now, I mean, just perform this seekbar capability utilizing the touch actions for some native app. You can also perform this in the native application, yeah, mobile web applications to support e-commerce industry having some seekbar for price. I mean, if you change the seekbar, the price will get changed, the category different you will get. So try to explain with this seekbar utilizing the touch action class, you will get to know more about it. Okay, so guys, that's all for today. Thank you for watching.